What if one mistake, one unlucky moment would cause your entire Minecraft world to disappear? Join me as I try and survive 100 days in hardcore Minecraft. I started off my first day as most people do, punching a tree, getting some wood, making a pickaxe, and getting some stone. My next priority was going to be food, so I set about murdering the local wildlife. I got lucky and stumbled upon some iron within the first couple minutes. It looked like everything was going great. After grabbing the iron, I set out to find a village because they would have everything I would need to set me up in the early game. And after a few minutes of searching, I finally found one. As I looted it though, my happiness turned to dismay pretty quickly because I realized this was probably the worst village in Minecraft history. I don't think this place even deserves to be called a village, it's literally one house. I then set about gathering some fish in the local lake, but they weren't for me to eat. They were actually going to be for me to tame this cat. Firstly, because cats are cute, but second, because creepers are actually scared of cats and will run away from them. My biggest fear in early game hardcore was creepers. Without enchanted diamond armor, you won't survive a point blank hit. After a second helping of fish, I finally tamed the cat and decided to name her Moon. As it was quickly turning nighttime, I tunneled into this hill to make a shelter. I didn't have a bed, so my best bet was just to go mining for the night. While I was mining, I ended up stumbling into a cave where I found the skeleton. The skeleton said the cave was his, which I disagreed with, and it didn't end well. While exploring, I nearly ended up falling down this ravine, but luckily I realized before it was too late. Before I could explore this ravine, I needed to head back up to the surface and smelt my iron. Full iron armor was basically required in order to survive. Now we're in day two, and while I waited for my iron to smelt, I decided to check out the local villagers. One was trapped inside a tree, and the other was on the edge of a cliff. After freeing the first villager from his leafy prison, he thanked me by immediately going into my house and deciding he was going to live with me. Bro, you literally have your own house. Get out of mine. But now I was ready to head into the ravine, I'd crafted myself a full set of iron armor. There were a ton of ores in this ravine, but I was really scared that a monster was going to spawn on the darker upper levels and then drop down on me. And that was exactly what happened. When this creeper dropped down behind me, my mind went completely blank. I was just panicking because I heard the hissing noise. I thought I was dead. I got launched into the air, and by some miracle, I accidentally placed my water, which stopped me from falling right into the lava below. I then boxed myself in and ate some bread very calmly, not scared at all, not in fear, nothing like that, because that would never happen. Why would I be scared? Shut up. I continued exploring the cave because I really wanted to find diamonds, and I finally did. Or should I say I found a diamond, because it was literally one. Why? That's fine though, I'll just find some more. Which I did. I then made myself a diamond sword and a diamond pickaxe, but I wasn't ready to stop mining just yet. I needed one more diamond to make an enchanting table. Day 3, I was still looking for those diamonds. After a bit more caving, I finally found that last diamond vein that I needed. Before heading back to the surface, I also mined some obsidian so I could have enough to make a nether portal and an enchantment table. When I returned from the mines, it was actually nighttime, so I had to wait out the night in my shelter. We're starting off day 4 by trading with this armorer. If I level him up enough, he's going to sell me enchanted diamond gear. While I was chopping down trees, a creeper ended up sneaking off me. Luckily, I was able to get away. He then got really mad and blew up. After trading basically my entire net worth of iron, I was able to finally get this armor to master, and then I could buy all the diamond enchanted gear. I then used all my emeralds to buy this diamond chestplate. For 4 days, this is some pretty good progress. I then set out to find a new village because, let's be honest, this one was pretty terrible. After a little while, I ended up finding this village and immediately got to stealing all their stuff. Did you say this was your gold? I think that's mine. It was beginning to get night, so I crafted myself a bed and had my first night's sleep. We're up bright and early on day 5. I've got way more stuff I need to steal. Among the stuff I stole, I took this purple bed because it was way cooler than my brown one. I found this wolf and ended up taming him with just one bone. Because I'm really uncreative and I had a cat named Moon, I decided why not name him Sun. I finished off day 5 by heading back to my shelter with Sun and Moon. In day 6, I headed back down into the caves. I was going to need a ton of iron to trade with the armorers. That was going to be the easiest way I would earn enough emeralds to get a bunch of good diamond gear. I ended up getting a ton of valuable resources, including a couple stacks of iron and a bit of gold. However, when I went to leave, it was still nighttime and I forgot to bring my bed, so instead I went looking for sugarcane to pass the time. With the current gear I had, trying to make my way through the forest to find my shelter would be a terrible idea because it'd just be a ton of monsters and it'd be really hard to get away. As the sun rose on day 7, I realized something. I was completely lost. Don't worry though, because within the first 2 minutes, I nearly walked up this cliff and died. After a ton of searching and running around the forest, I managed to find the terrible village that I called home. On day 8, I left the tiny village. It was time to build my new house. I found this area when I was looking for that village earlier, and I thought it'd be the perfect place. I spent the rest of the day gathering wood and sorting out my stuff, ready to build the house. The whole of day 9, I just built the house. I wanted to make sure it would stand the test of 100 days. I was able to get the first floor done and slept in my new house. Day 10 came around and I'm still working on the house. There was a lot that needed to be done. I also found a horse which I tamed because I'd stolen a saddle from the village earlier so I'd be able to ride it. It was unfortunately a pretty slow horse, but at least now I had some method of transport that was faster than walking. Unfortunately, I don't have a lead yet, so sorry man, you're gonna have to go in the hole. By the end of the day, I'd managed to finish off the second floor and start the roof. Day 11 started with me working on the roof. Luckily, I had just enough cobblestone to finish it off. These stairs were honestly really annoying to snap into place. I finished the roof, and that was the outer part of my house done. Now I had to sort out the interior. Day 12, I started out by putting down some important stuff in my house, like some blast furnaces and some barrels. I also started work on a stable on the side of my house because I felt bad for my horse having to live in a hole. Day 13, I was building my stable. I went through quite a few different designs before I finally found one that I liked. I then built this little cobblestone roof for my front porch. Day 14, I was shoveling dirt. I had to sort out this floor. You know, pets are great in Minecraft, but sometimes you really just want them to move. Like, come on, son. I'm trying to place a wood plank there and you're kind of right in the way. I made this spruce plank pattern on the floor over in this corner because I had all my furnaces. I thought it could be a kind of like a kitchen area. I placed some pumpkins outside my house for a bit of decoration and to add a bit more color. I also added this nice path and a gate for my stable. My horse is about to get a major upgrade in where he lives. I organized all my possessions into some chests and instead of sleeping, I went out at night to try and kill some monsters. I wanted skeletons because I wanted to make bone meal because then I could bone meal the grass outside my house and just grow a bunch of flowers. It would just look really nice. I found these guys and they just started doing the work for me. They just shot each other. After I got the bones that I needed, I went off to bed. I didn't want to push my luck with all the monsters that were outside. On day 15, my glass was done smelting. I turned it into white stained glass and started finally putting in the windows. After finishing off my windows, I started setting up a farm. I needed to get a stable source of food. Finished off day 15, and let's just get a little bit of appreciation for Moon here. Day 16, I added in some potatoes to my farm and finished off the enclosure. Were these fences unnecessary? Yeah. Did it look nice? I mean, sort of. I was recording this at 3 a.m. and it was starting to have an effect on my gameplay. For some reason, I built this pumpkin farm with the middle strip running straight to the center with water and farmland on the other side. It was not going to grow either way. Instead of patching up the water trench and digging a new one, I instead dug up an entire row of pumpkins that I had just planted and replanted them. Day 17, I started by planting my sugarcane around this pond. I didn't make a proper sugarcane farm, so I was planning to make an automated one later when I had more resources. I then headed off to the nearby village to trade some of my iron for emeralds and also to steal more stuff because I hadn't taken it all last time. I ended up finding a villager with this sheep in this wooden flowerbed thing, and all I could say is I definitely need to call the police. I was able to rescue the poor sheep. I think he's going to be traumatized for the rest of his life. Day 18, I began the really fun and not time-consuming task of transporting a villager all the way over to my base. By the end of the day, though, I was able to get the villager back to my base. Thankfully, my house and this village are really close. Day 19, I was digging out a hole for the villager breeder. I could have built something above ground, but I just finished my house, so I didn't really want to have to spend loads of time gathering resources. I mean, yeah, it looks terrible, but it'll get the job done. After a few more rails, I was able to get the villager down the hole. I used some ladders with a trapdoor as a way of getting out, and then I went off to find some sheep so I could make more beds. When I came back from shearing the sheep, I realized I made a pretty big mistake with the entrance and exit thing. I've forgotten villagers could actually climb ladders, so as soon as I opened the trapdoor, this guy ran for it. Obviously, after all the effort I've gone through to getting him here, I wasn't going to let him get away. I put him back in the minecart, and back inside he went. You will enjoy your new life here. Day 20, I created a more secure iron door. Now I can enter and leave, but the villagers are stuck. I traded almost all my iron to this guy to try and get him to master level. It was worth it though because he started selling me sharpness 2 diamond swords. This was amazing not only because sharpness is an awesome enchantment but also because I could keep buying swords off him and then combine them on an anvil to make a greater sharpness level. Day 21, I'm back to farming. My small wheat patch was fine but I was going to need way more if I was going to make some good emeralds and also craft bread to make the villagers breed. Instead of sleeping, I went mining. I really wanted to get some more resources because I traded basically all my iron away and I also didn't have many diamonds. I got really lucky and found some diamonds after only a couple minutes but I was going to need a lot more. I found a pretty decent cave system. I had to be really careful here because I've forgotten a water bucket and there were all these lakes of lava. It's day 22 and I'm still down here mining. I found some more diamonds. After grabbing a couple buckets of lava, I started heading out. There was no need for me to stay down here much longer. I had a ton of iron. I had the diamonds that I needed. And I didn't have a water bucket. So if I fell in this lava, it was basically game over. Day 23 was pretty uneventful. I just did a bit more farming and made an animal pen. Day 24, I started work on a new farm and also managed to get the sheep in my animal pen. Day 25, I was able to find a cow and 3 sheep and take them back to my pen. After a bit more farming, I headed off back to the village. I wanted to get another villager. I was going to be trying a new method to get him home where I place down a job station block like a grindstone and then they walk towards it. You then break the grindstone and then replace it and they'll keep running towards it. I didn't have too much luck throughout day 25, but day 26 things went much more smoothly and I was able to get him back to my base. Day 27 was a simple day. Farming, shearing the sheep, doing a bit of trading with the villagers and chopping some wood. Day 28 I went mining. I actually found a decent amount of diamonds, 7 in total, and I also found a ton of useful resources like gold and iron. Day 29 I started work on the Verger Trading Hall. Day 30 and we're still working on the Verger Trading Hall, but it's starting to take shape. By the end of the day, I finished the main structure and now I started work on the roof. I didn't want to get annoyed by monsters the whole night though while I was trying to build my roof, so I headed to bed. Day 31, I started building the granite roof on top of the Verger Trading Hall. I didn't have enough granite to finish the roof, but before I got that, I needed to go off and get more sand because I didn't have any glass for windows. Day 32, I went out to gather more granite for the roof. I thought I gathered enough, but unfortunately not. Day 33, what could possibly happen today? As it turned out, something did happen. I did some more farming because my crops had grown, and then the wandering trader showed up. Even though his trades were complete trash as always, I didn't want to kill him because that would just be kind of unnecessary, or so I thought, because he and his llamas committed a crime which I would never be able to forgive. That's right, they trampled all over my freshly planted potatoes. Filled with blind rage at losing my beloved potatoes, I decimated the wandering trader and his llamas. I did a bunch more farming, and by now I had so many wheat seeds. I bred my sheep and then traded all the wheat that I just harvested to my vergers. I then finished off the windows in the verger trading hall. Instead of going to bed though, I went on a mining trip, firstly because I need more granite to finish off that roof, and also because I wanted some more resources. When I saw a skeleton kill that innocent bat, I knew that he had to die. And when I killed him, he actually ended up dropping his enchanted bow. I decided that instead of putting on an anvil with a regular bow to fix it up, I would wait until I had a proper enchanting area set up, enchant a regular bow, and then combine the two together to make a super powerful bow. I emerged from the mines on day 34, organized my stuff, and then chucked some bread at the vergers. It was a good day. Day 35, I used the granite that I'd got from all that mining to finish off the roof of the verger hall. I also added a bit of depth to the exterior. Day 36, I was gathering up both oak and birch wood. I wanted to make a cool pattern for the floor of my trading hall. While I was clearing out a space behind the hall, my iron shovel broke. I didn't have any iron on me, so I had to make a stone one like a peasant. I then shoveled away the floor of the verger trading hall with my very slow stone shovel. I then added the oak and birch planks to the floor before using these spruce stairs to make it seem like a really long corridor. Wasn't sure about the whole corridor thing with the spruce stairs, but I decided to leave it be. Day 37, I started getting vergers out with the breeder and into the hall. For some reason, I decided to use the rail and the minecart system, even though I could have just done the whole workstation thing that had worked so well only a couple weeks ago. Of course, the whole minecart thing was really annoying, and I have no idea why I did it. After a lot of pain, I finally managed to get this farmer into position in the trading hall. But then I got extremely scared because as I was trying to sort him out and get him in his little compartment, I actually ended up punching him. Now, this doesn't sound too bad, but because of the amount of vergers in the breeder, an iron golem had spawned on the land, I really didn't want that thing coming over to kill me because they do so much damage. Luckily, the golem didn't seem mad and I was finally able to get the verger into his trading station. On day 38, I grabbed a bunch of spruce leaves using shears to try and decorate my verger hall. I ended up not liking it though, so it was kind of a waste of time. I also killed off this iron golem, not because it was mad at me, but because in case of future accidents, I didn't want this massive iron monster coming after me. I'd learned my lesson with the vergers and it was so much easier getting this one in. Well, I say easy, there was a little bit of shoving involved. Day 39, I realized another iron golem had already spawned in, so killing that one earlier basically been a waste of time. I then had to spend the morning resetting the second verger's trades because all he wanted to do was buy carrots. Either you're gonna buy some wheat from me or you're gonna be useless. Which one is it gonna be? I then spent the rest of day 39 harvesting wheat and selling it to my vergers. Day 40, I started work on a cow pen. I really need leather because I didn't even have a single bookshelf for an enchanting table. The leaves that the wandering trader had happily given to me made getting these cows back way easier than it was getting the sheep back. I didn't have to wait for them to slowly walk towards the wheat. I can now take them with me with the leads. There's only two in here right now, but trust me, give me a week and this pen's going to be absolutely overcrowded. I had also accumulated an absolute ton of wheat seeds and I decided, well, why not put them to good use? I started hoeing out a massive field where I was just going to plant a ton of wheat. Day 41, I'm still working on the wheat farm. I wanted this thing to be big enough to plant at least 4 stacks of seeds. I also farmed up more of my pumpkins and expanded my pumpkin farm. Eventually, I want this whole valley to just be full of pumpkins. Day 42, I headed straight into the mines. Can you guess why? Yeah, I needed more resources. I kept trading away all my iron to my vergers. On top of that, my diamond pickaxe was nearly broken and I had barely any diamonds to replace it. I wasn't even full diamond armor. Day 43, I was still mining. I was trying to gather as many resources as I could. After emerging from the mines on day 44 and smelting a bunch of iron, I headed up to the verger breeder to talk to his toolsmith. Aw, they grow up so fast. Weren't you a kid, like 20 minutes ago. After selling a ton of coal and iron to him, he was getting close to master rank. By the time I had maxed out his iron trade though, it was already night time, so I decided to just grab a bed in the verger breeder. It's the morning of day 45, and while I wait for the toolsmith's trades to refresh, I went out to expand my pumpkin farm. After stacks of iron, he finally reached master rank, which meant he would finally sell me an enchanted diamond pickaxe. This was the reason why I'd gone mining for so much iron in the first place, because mining for diamonds can take a while, so why not just have it so I can have a bunch of diamond tools tools on demand whenever I need them. I spent the rest of the day harvesting my wheat, which was going to take a while because I just had so much of it now. It became nighttime and I was still trying to plant these wheat seeds. I wanted to get it all done before the morning. Bro, I'm just trying to farm some wheat. Can you go away? Day 46, I checked upon my cows. I've been breeding them for a couple of days and the numbers were already increasing by a lot. I then headed into the verger breeder to trade with his armorer. I wanted to max him out like the verger in that old village because then I would have diamond armor on demand. It was very painful buying a bunch of useless chain boots from him just to level him up, but you gotta do what you gotta do. I then went down into the mine and threw all his hard work into a pool of lava. I then went back and bought a bunch of shields off him. Wow, really useful to own 20 shields. He reached expert level and started selling me enchanted diamond boots and diamond leggings. The boots especially were really useful because they had feather falling too. Again, like the plans I have for my sword, I could buy a bunch of these boots and then combine them all to give them a really high level on the feather falling. I then created a disposal system with a bucket of lava because I really didn't need all these shields. I then harvested all my pumpkins ready to sell to the villagers tomorrow because my wallet was sort of crying after buying about 20 pairs of boots, a bunch of shields, and diamond boots. Day 47, I sold off all my pumpkins and now I had a decent amount of emeralds again. Today's useless item that I'd be buying to level up the armor was chain chest plates. He finally hit master and I was able to buy the final piece of enchanted diamond armor that I needed, a helmet. I bred my cows a bit more and knew that soon I'd be able to make books and then max out my enchanting table. I went mining with my new diamond pickaxe and life was so much easier with that efficiency too. I also ended up finding some diamonds, which is kind of cool. I stumbled upon this cave and found two more veins of diamonds, but I decided not to mine these because I didn't have fortune on my pickaxe. It would pretty much be a waste. It turned to day 48 while I was in the mines, and as I was leaving, I built this cobblestone staircase leading up because it was really annoying having to jump up every single block. As you can see, the cow pen is growing by a lot. I'm getting quite a few of these now, but I can get way more. Another wandering trader showed up while I was breeding my cows. I had a look through his trades. Obviously, they were terrible, and then I don't know how it happened, guys, but suddenly, he died. Not sure how that happened. Oh, and his llamas as well. I farmed up some more pumpkins, traded those to my villagers, and now that I've bred my cows, it was time to start gathering some leather. With the leather I got, I was able to set up an enchantment table with just 3 bookshelves, but that's fine because we'll get way more very soon. Day 49 started out with some pumpkin farming, and then I gathered a bunch of wood. I was running pretty low, and it would be nice to just have some on hand whenever I needed it. For the rest of day 49, I farmed my pumpkins. Day 50, I'm trying to make an auto-composter. I have so many seeds, so I was hoping I could turn them all into bone meal. At the time, I had no idea how to build one of these, so I didn't get it to work. I harvested all my wheat and sold it off to the villagers. Day 51, I made some improvements to my path. It needs some more detail. I then began gathering leather because my cow pen was pretty much full. With my newfound leather, I was able to make 6 more bookshelves. I then went searching for a new horse because mine was insanely slow. It didn't work though. All the horses I found were just as slow. Just gotta let you guys know that the game audio from days 52 to 55 is bugged for some reason, so you actually can't hear anything. It is back on day 56 though. Day 52, I used all that wood I've been gathering to start building a bridge across my pumpkin farm. Day 53, I gathered enough wood to keep building my bridge. I think these stripped spruce logs look really nice. I started day 54 by using some of my gold to make more golden apples. They're amazing healing and I wanted to minimize my chances of dying as much as possible for pretty obvious reasons. I gathered some more leather and added these stairs to my bridge to give it some more depth. As night fell, I was finally able to craft enough bookshelves to max out my enchanting table. I had 46 levels, so I used a grindstone to remove my enchantments and then start going for new ones. I ended up getting protection 4 on my chest plate as well as some other good enchantments on my other gear. I combined these two pickaxes together to make an even stronger one. Day 55, I bought more sharpness 2 swords for my weaponsmith and combined them all in an anvil. Unfortunately, I didn't have enough levels to make a sharpness 5 sword, and I spent the rest of the day finishing my bridge. Day 56, I gathered a bunch of obsidian. I was going to be building another portal. Because I now have fortune on my pickaxe, I went back to mine these diamonds I'd found. Fortune is just such an amazing enchantment. I got 14 diamonds from that. Day 57, I built my nether portal on the side of this hill. Well, I messed up the first time and had to mine a whole row of obsidian, but I did get sorted. I spent the rest of the day farming pumpkins and making profits. Day 58, it was time for me to head to the nether. I was extremely scared because of always had bad experiences there, and I've also lost a previous hardcore world to the nether. Yeah, this wasn't the first time I tried to record this video. I actually had a previous hardcore world which I ended up losing because of a terrible nether spawn. This time though, I survived. I spawned in a crimson forest and found this piglin, so I started trading with him. Didn't get any pearls, but he gave me a fire resistance potion, which is amazing because if I accidentally fell in lava, I now had a way to survive. Grabbed some of these shroom lights and found some more piglins. I traded almost all my gold to them and didn't get a single pearl trade, but I did get 2 more fire res potions. It's day 59 and I'm using my new fire res to explore the nether in hopes of finding a fortress. Didn't find one, but I did find this random piece of ancient debris while tunneling through some netherrack. My inventory is pretty full, so I headed home. Day 60, I returned to the nether. It's time to find a fortress. Fell in lava and very calmly drank my fire res. It was a very calm situation where I remained calm. I crafted a warp fungus on a stick so that I could ride a strider. It'd be so much easier than trying to bridge across these massive lava lakes. Like an idiot, I then fell off the strider. Unfortunately, that would be another fire res potion I had to use. I've only got one left now. I found out the only way to get a saddle off a strider is to kill it. Sorry, bro. I don't know why I always have such terrible luck with nether fortresses. I got the achievement for finding all the nether biomes, and I still haven't found a fortress. Had a pretty close encounter with some ghasts because for some reason I decided it'd be a good idea to play tennis with fireballs. Traded with some more piglins and got another fire res potion, but still no pearl. I was pretty sick of the nether, so I bridged over to this ruined portal and headed back to the overworld. I ended up spawning in a cave, so now I'm gonna have to dig my way out. Day 61, I'm over 5,000 blocks away from my base. I have no idea what I was doing here and why I didn't just go back to the nether, but for some reason I started heading back on foot. I know it says day 60 in my coordinates, but that's because when you start a Minecraft world, the game starts counting from day 0 rather than day 1. Just in case you're confused on why I'm so far out, 1 block traveled in the nether equals 8 blocks traveled in the overworld. So even though I hadn't gone that far in the nether, I'd gone a huge distance in the overworld. I just kept traveling and quickly it turned to night. Tons of monsters were starting to spawn in, and because I hadn't slept in a couple days because of being in the nether, phantoms started swooping in trying to bite me. All in all, was not a fun experience and I wouldn't recommend. After a lot of running, I found what I was searching for, a village. Finally, I could get a bed and sleep. Day 62, I found an igloo and got lucky because it spawned a hidden room underneath where you're supposed to cure the zombie villager. Nope, thanks to the golden apple and weakness potion though. After a YouTube tutorial, I learned how to make one of these speedrunner nether portals. It was time for me to begin the fortress search once again. The spawn didn't look very promising until I realized I was right next to a fortress. Finally, some good luck. It looked like my luck was really starting to pick up when I killed this wither skeleton. He dropped a skull. While I was trying to kill this blaze, my sweeping edge enchantment meant I hit this pigment as well, and now every pigment in a 100-mile radius now wanted me dead. I had to quickly pillar up in order to escape, all the while this blaze was trying to knock me off with fireballs. After a ton of searching, I finally found a blaze spawn and gathered all the blaze rods I would need. Day 63, I was heading back to another to my original portal using the help of this friendly strider. Oh man, I need that saddle back. I'm so sorry. I got the saddle with zero harm done. I knew my original portal was around this crimson forest somewhere, but I just couldn't find it. Still searching day 64. Wait, I built that cobblestone. I can't describe the feeling of relief when I finally found my portal. I then spent the rest of the day sorting out my stuff. I used all the XP I gained to combine these two swords together and finally get sharpness 5. Day 65, I'm back to some good old farming. I missed you guys. Day 66, I'm adding some more detail to my path with this coarse dirt. Added these stripped spruce logs to my villager hall because those gaps between the walls were annoying me. Day 67, I did some more farming and added some details to my house that I'd overlooked when I first built it. I also terraformed the hill because it didn't look right. Day 68, I realized I hadn't seen sun or moon around, but I had a pretty strong idea of where they'd ended up. I checked the nether and sure enough they were there, as well as a couple of iron golems. After rescuing sun and moon from the nether, I built the staircase from my house down to one of the wheat fields, which I would then use a total of about 2 times. Now it's day 69. A normal day. After some villager trading, I headed into the mines to gather more gravel to craft coarse dirt. I also wanted gold and I'll explain why in a minute. I found quite a few diamonds and got way more than just the ores that I found because of my fortune pickaxe. Day 70, I finished up mining and then headed home. Day 71, here's the reason why I was mining all that gold. I turned one of my villagers into a cleric and an expert rank cleric sell enderpearls. This would save me from having to farm endermen in the warp forest biome in the nether, because I could instead just buy all the pearls I needed. The cleric reached expert and I bought all the enderpearls I could need. I then started work on a sugarcane farm, which as you'll quickly see was the worst sugarcane farm that's ever been built in the history of Minecraft. Day 72, and can you see what's wrong? Yeah, I put the water in the wrong place so the pistons aren't going to harvest the sugarcane. They harvest air instead. While I was building my sugarcane farm, a wandering trader showed up, and for once he actually had something I wanted, a jungle sapling. Kind of a scam at 5 emeralds, but whatever, I'll take it. Day 73, I'm still working on the sugarcane farm. How I didn't realize my mistake yet, I will never know. Added in a roof and doesn't it all look nice? Nice and useless. Day 74, I realized what I'd done wrong. And then do you know what I did? Still built it wrong. Now the water's in front of the sugarcane, so when the pistons harvest it, it's all just gonna fall in the water and not the hoppers. I farm my crops for the rest of the day, unaware of the mistake I've made. Day 75, I headed into the villager breeder. It was time to get a librarian so I could get mending books. That was the plan anyway, but then he offered feather falling 3 and it was just way too good to pass up. With some moderate pain, I got him into the villager hall and applied the new book to my boots. Day 76, I'm checking my broken sugarcane farm. At the time, I was so confused as to why I wasn't getting any cane. I did a ton of farming to earn emeralds and started trading with this Fletcher. You need a couple stacks of arrows for the Ender Dragon fight, and I could buy 16 for just one emerald. Day 77, I went mining again. I needed more gold to craft golden apples, and I traded all my gold to the cleric. Unfortunately, day 78 through 81 had the same bug again where you can't hear any gameplay audio. I'm really sorry. Day 78, still mining. Day 79, finally done with the mining, and at long last, I finally realized why the sugarcane farm wasn't working. Now it's day 80, we're 4/5 of the way through 100 days. Found a zombie horde in the villager hall. How did you guys even get in here? It was going to be a long day. I wanted to get a mending librarian and get him in the trading hall. All the way at the end of day 80, and he finally started selling mending books. Day 81, I bought 3 mending books, but before I used them, it was time to fix up an old enchanted bow dropped by a skeleton. I enchanted a normal bow and ended up getting infinity, which is nice, but now I had 3 stacks of arrows that I just bought that I'll never need. Oh well. I put mending on my pickaxe and chestplate, but didn't have enough levels to put it on the sword. I carved this pumpkin because then I could wear it on my head and look at the Enderman without them trying to kill me. The last thing I wanted while fighting the dragon was a horde of Enderman rushing towards me at 100 miles an hour. I also did some potion brewing. I wanted to make potions of slow falling so that I wouldn't die to fall damage against the dragon. Google said you could make a potion of leaping and then turn it into slow falling with a fermented spider eye. Google lied. This sucked because the ingredient needed to brew slow falling is phantom membrane and I didn't have any. I was going to need to go 3 Minecraft nights without sleeping for the phantoms to spawn. For once in Minecraft, I was happy to not have a max enchanted sword. While trying to kill the zombie, the sweeping edge enchantment meant I accidentally hit Moon as well. If I had fire aspect on my sword, she would have died because this one hit took her down to 1 heart. Day 82, I expanded the pumpkin farm as far as it would go. It's my main source of income, so I might as well make it bigger. I then gathered some spruce wood because I was going to be building another bridge. By the end of the day, I finished the bridge and I think it looks pretty nice. Day 83, it rained. A lot. It was a pretty slow day. I only did some farming and trading. Day 84, I'm making a ton of beds because I'm going netherite mining. When I entered the nether, I was greeted with this sight. The amount of villagers in my base kept spawning iron golems and they must have kept walking into the nether portal, which would then cause a new iron golem to spawn. But forget my new army of iron golems, it was time to go netherite mining. I had decent luck with ancient debris, but not amazing. I found 5 pieces. It was day 85 and I was preparing to head back. When I tried to leave, I realized I'd forgotten to bring gold armor and now the entire piglin army wanted me dead. With the amount of gold in the nether, it was pretty easy to make a pair of gold boots and then I just walked out unscathed. Apparently, shiny shoes makes pig monsters not want to kill you. That's a great tip for life. I spent some time making a custom banner for my shield and went with this design. Night settled and finally I could go out and hunt phantoms. After a few minutes, I was able to get the precious phantom membrane and soon I'd have everything I needed to fight the Ender Dragon. Day 86, I was able to use the debris I found in the nether to make 1 netherite ingot. I brewed the potions of slow falling and some healing potions on top just in case. I applied the netherite ingot to my chest plate and then slept. Tomorrow, I would start my journey. Day 87, I started searching for the stronghold. Seemed like it was a fair distance away from my base because I searched all day and didn't find it. Day 88, though, I found the stronghold. I was extremely nervous because I was pretty unlucky and 3 of my 15 eyes of Ender had broken instead of dropping again when I threw them, so if another had broke, I wouldn't have been able to activate the end portal. I then spent the whole day searching for the portal room. The stronghold had generated with a ravine running through it and I even found some diamonds. I searched the entire stronghold and couldn't find a library, nor could I find the portal room. Day 89, I watched a couple of tutorials on YouTube to try and find out where the portal room was. A few recommended that you dig through the walls at the end of each corridor, so I tried it and after a few attempts, it actually worked. I'll never understand why strongholds can generate like this. It's really annoying having to fumble around for hours because the important rooms are completely disconnected from the main body of the stronghold. The library has some decent enchanted books, but of course the portal room was my goal. I activated the portal, organized my inventory, and then stared at the portal for a few seconds. I knew there was going to be no second chance if I messed up this fight. After getting the worst end spawn of my life, I started getting to work on the healing crystals. Landed some nice bow shots, and thanks to my slow falling potions, the fight was much smoother than I expected. The only time I was ever really in danger was when I got caught in the dragon's breath, but even then I just healed it off with a gapple. Even though the fight wasn't super difficult, it was so satisfying to have beaten the dragon in hardcore. While I was in the end, it turned to day 90. I grabbed the dragon egg and then headed through the end gateway. It was time to get an elytra. I spent the whole day looking for an end city and somehow didn't find one. Day 91, I found an end city, but unfortunately it didn't spawn a ship. There was still some decent loot though, and I killed a bunch of shulkers to get shells. Day 92, I found another end city and this one did have a ship. I also made sure to grab the dragon head. I wasn't done looting yet though. I wanted a backup elytra just in case something happened. It didn't take me too long before I found another end city and this one also had a ship. After looting the city, grabbing the elytra and dragon head, it was time to go home. Before I did that though, I had to use a ton of XP to fix my boots. They were nearly broken, so I combined them with another pair I found. Day 93, I made my way through the portal and returned to the overworld. Unfortunately, because I'd had to sleep once while I was searching for the stronghold, my spawn was no longer set at my house. Once I found my house and sorted out my stuff, I started working on a treasure room. My storage was super unorganized and I also wanted to lay out some of the cool items I'd obtained throughout this 100 day playthrough. I had a lot of obsidian from mining ender chests while I was raiding the end cities, and I had a bunch of crying obsidian just lying around, which I thought would look really nice on the wall. Day 94, I finished the storage room. I was originally gonna have the stone bricks as quartz, but I didn't have enough. Day 95, I started organizing all my items into the chests. It was gonna take a while because I was gonna have to sort through a lot of stuff. Day 96, I'm still organizing. This took forever, but it's gonna be so much easier in the future to find the items that I need. Finally finished, and I built the shrine to the dragon egg. I decorated it with the 2 dragon heads I got and also my wither skull. This thing was expensive, but it looks cool. Day 97, I got to work using all the levels I'd obtained from killing the dragon to enchant my gear. As you can see, after all of that, I didn't have enough to combine these 2 diamond swords together to create basically the best sword in the game. Oh well, that'll be for 200 days. Seems like I'm getting deja vu because yes, I'm back to farming. I was in an awkward spot because there was only 3 days left of the 100, so I couldn't start working on a new project because I'd never be able to finish it in only 3 days. Oh hey, do you remember when I actually wanted you guys? Day 98, this creeper tried to stop me from getting to 100 days. As usual, I panicked when I heard it tick down behind me, but my armor at this point was so strong I easily survived. Still not an experience I want to repeat. I then killed a bunch of cows because my leather supply had been drained due to all the item frames I've been crafting. I farmed my pumpkins and started work on leveling up this librarian. A master rank now sent name tags and I really wanted one. Day 99, I gave my villagers some bread and continued trading with them. But no one cares cares about day 99 because now it's day 100. 100 days survived in hardcore Minecraft. My house is pretty bare with all my chests downstairs and my storage room, so I spent the rest of the day making this blue creeper rug. Not sure why I'm going with a creeper theme rug when they've tried to kill me so many times, but you can't deny they're one of Minecraft's defining features. I purchased a name tag, and what else would I use it for apart from properly naming the best cat? And so here we are at the end of 100 days. This video was a ton of fun to make and I really hope you enjoyed it. This video actually took over 30 hours to record and edit, so if you guys could help me out by dropping a like, maybe even subscribing, it would really mean a lot to me. If you want to see 200 days, let me know down in the comments below. I'm more than happy to keep making these videos. That's it from me. Peace.